Hello my fellow card lovers and welcome to the grand finale of this tutorial on modeling a spiral casing using Autodex Inventor. We have the two mounting posts left to do, so without further ado, let's get to it. Since the two posts will share this 60mm diameters, we are going to start by creating user parameters for them. So we will have B1 diameter for this first one and B2 diameter for the second one. So let's get back to the master part for that. And parameters, then underneath we will add a new parameter which is B1 underscore diameter, and the value is 60mm. Then enter. We will copy this, add numeric, paste, then E2. Maybe I should have this like this. So enter, and I will do the same for this one like this, and I will copy this and make the two equals. So this should be a capital D. Enter, and that will be it. And then I will go to the make part. So this will be boss one with the standard part template. Then the parameters, we are going to use the B1 diameter, unlink this, and for the name of the assembly we will have this again, then OK. And now we will edit the component, and as we did plenty of time before, we are going to select the reference geometry. And for this component we will use the top face of the sheet metal 3 to 4. So modified, copy object, we want a face and with the surface option, so this one. Okay, now for the sketch plane, we are going to use an offset plane at a distance of 650.5 from the XZ plane. So we will use this offset from plane, and we are going to look for the XZ plane, and the value is 560.5. Okay, now select the work plane, then create sketch. And the sketch is simply a cycle, and the value of the diameter of this cycle is the parameter we have, B1 diameter. So we click to select it, then accept the selection. Now for the position, we need to be aligned with the vertical axis or the horizontal axis depending on how you are looking. And we should have this 105mm offset from the origin. So let's see, we want an horizontal constraint first between the center point and the origin, and then we will add a distance of 105, then enter and finish the sketch. And now we create the extrude feature, and we want the extrude to stop at this reference geometry. So instead of this distance option, we will use the two option, and we will select the face and OK. Now we can hide the work plane, then this reference surface. So escape first, select it and turn off the visibility. OK, now for the hole, we cannot make it inside the part, and the reason is that as you can see, the hole is going through both the boss and the sheet metal component, and in the real world it is most likely to be drilled after the two components are welded together. In the CAD world, one way of handling this kind of feature is to do it at the assembly level. So we are going to exit the component and return to the top level assembly, and from there we are going to create the hole using the whole feature in the 3D model tab. So we select the whole directly. And for the placement this time, you are not going to use the from sketch option as we did. We are going to use this concentric. And the first input should be the plane normal to the axis of the hole, so this face. And then we need a concentric reference. So we select this face. And now we want to define the size of the holes. Here we do not have the indication of what type of hole it is, so we are going to look in this view and we will see that it is a 1/2 inch cast pipe thread. So we are going to make sure that we have the thread option selected, and for the type we are going to look for the GB pipe threads, and we should select here the 1/2, but it is not available, and this is because what is driving this destination is the size. And the value for this should be 20.955. So this one, as you can see now, we have the proper designation. And for the thread depth, we want something like 20 millimeters. And for the termination, since we want the thread to go through this both and this metal component, we should select this option 2. And as you can see, we cannot select the face of the sheet metal component. So what we are going to do instead is to select the XZ plane from the origin folder and click on OK. And as you can see, we will have this error message: errors occurred during update. And if we expand it, we will see that there is a problem with the extrusion in the mounting boss, and the message is telling us that the attempted operation did not find any intersection between the tool body and the selected tool termination face or plane. Change the termination definition or the feature profile position. So it is pretty clear what is happening. The hole is changing the face we use to trim this extrusion. That's why Inventor is no longer able to properly compute the feature. We will click on accept to dismiss the warning and create the hole feature. Then we are going to have to go back and edit the component to fix this issue. The geometry is not longer displayed, and there is a warning in front of the extrusion, and the warning is saying modeling failure. And if we go back to this face we used to define the extent of the extrusion, you can see that there is a hole in this face. This is why the extrusion is no longer working. The lesson to learn here is that we cannot use this surface to define the extrusion. To work around this issue, what we have to do is to make sure that the surface we will use to trim the extrusion will not be linked to this sheet metal component. And there are two possible solutions. The easy solution is to break the adaptivity for this surface, but we will have to update it manually if it is required. And the clean solution is to rebuild the surface from scratch using the same sketches we used to build this sheet metal component 0304. We are going to choose the second solution. So we will have to go back to the master part and add the two sketches 03 and 04 into this component, recreate this internal face, then offset it to obtain the external surface that we are going to use to trim the extrusion and get to the final geometry. Okay, so until now we have been using the make part tool to create new parts and derive geometry and parameters from the master part, but in this case we will have to proceed differently to copy the sketches we need from the master part, since our component is already created. To do so, we are going to move to this 3D model tab, and inside the create panel we will select the derive component tool, and now we have to select in our work folder the master part, so it will be this one. So we'll open it and we are going to select the sketches we need from the master part, so this one and this one. And then as parameters we are going to use, okay, we deselect this one, and maybe there is also something here to deselect, so this, deselect this, this. And for parameters we are going to use the thickness, which is already selected, and I don't know why these are selected, so we are just going to deselect them. I think it's a bug. Inventor is remembering what we use the last time we invoked the make part tool. You see all the parameters for the stiffness are by default activated, so we are going to make sure that we do not bring parameters we do not need. Okay, we'll see, everything looks okay. Inside this, nothing is selected. Good, and that's it. We have what we want, so we're just going to click on OK. And as you can see, a new derived part feature is added in the bottom of the feature tree. We are going to select it and move it on the top, and then we select this end of part marker and we will drag it underneath the new derived part feature. And as you can see, we have the two sketches 3 and 4 added, so we are going to use it to create a lofted feature as we did when we were modeling this sheet metal component. And we'll use this loft feature inside the create panel of the 3D model tab, so loft tool, and we make sure that the output is a surface body. And in the curves tab we make sure that we activate this bottom to enable the selection of sketches for the first section. So the first section will be this arc, and we'll click again on this to activate the selection for the second section, which will be this one. And you can see on the preview we have a nice surface created, and it is properly matching the internal face of this sheet metal component. So we'll click on OK to finish, and then we will offset the surface using this thicken offset tool in the 3D model tab again and the modified panel. So we make sure first that the output is a surface body. We select this, and for the distance we will look for the thickness and we will use it as parameter. And for the side we will keep this selected, and then OK. And now you can see we have this surface which is also nicely matching the external face of the sheet metal component 3 to 4. Okay, so now this is not longer useful, so we are going just to hide this. So we'll turn off the visibility and we remove the end of part marker to the bottom of the feature tree. And what we will do next is to select this copied surface, and we will right click and delete it. Now we will have this message, delete features, additionally delete, and you can see that the dependent sketches and features box is activated. So we will make sure that we untick this, and then OK. If you don't do that, it will delete the sketch and the extrusion, and we do not want that. So we will click on OK, and next we will come back to the extrusion and right click and select edit feature. Now we have to redefine the extent, so the two option is already active. We make sure that we activate the selection and we select this surface, and then OK. Now we can see a solid body, and we are ready to go back to the whole tool in the assembly environment. So we will click this button and return to the assembly. We will move on the top of the tree. As you can see, we have our hole which is nicely created, and we can also have a look inside this component. Oops, excuse me. So edit, and you can see everything is fine, no warning, no nothing. And as expected, there is obviously no hole feature in the part, since it should reside only in the top assembly where it was created. Okay, now we return to the assembly, and one thing I didn't mention earlier is that for assembly feature, you can check what components are involved or impacted by expanding the node underneath the feature. For instance, here we can see that the feature is applied to these two components. Okay, and this will conclude this first mounting board. So now we can move to the second one. For the second mounting board and last component of our spiral casing, we are going to create an extrusion from a cycle located at 920 from the X Z plane and at 130 from the Y Z plane. And the sketch plane will be at a distance of 250 from the XY plane. The both diameter will be 60 millimeters, and it will extend up to the intersection of these two sheet metal components, 1112 and 1213. As we did for the first mounting board, we are going to have to create from scratch the surface which will define the termination of the boss. We are going to start the component from the master part, and right away we will invoke the make part tool. The component name will be B2, as you can guess. The template will be the standard millimeter template. We are going to use the sketches 11, 12 and 13 as input. And as parameters, we are going to use the thickness. Then as user parameters, we are going to use this B2 diameter. And that will be it. We will make sure that we unlink the sheet metal styles. And that's pretty much all we need. So we will click on OK. And as you can see, the component is created and placed at the bottom of the assembly tree, and the two sketches are added in the component. So we will right away double click to edit the component, and we will create our reference surface as we did previously using the loft tool. So first we make sure that the output will be a surface body, then we will click to add the first section, so this sketch 11. Then the second section will be this sketch 12. Next, okay. Now for the next surface, we activate the loft tool again. And for the first input, we are going to move close to the edge we want to select, and then wait for this menu and click on the black triangle to access the second possible selection, which is this edge, and then click to activate the selection for the second input, which will be this sketch 13, and then okay. Now we have to offset the two surfaces, so we are going to use this thickened offset tool. We make sure that the surface output is the active option, then we select this face. For the distance, we will use the thickness, obviously. Then apply to create the first one. Then we will select this, and the thickness parameter is already in use as the distance. So we just click on OK to finish the second offset surface. We will hide these two so that they are not in our way when we will perform the next steps. For now, we are going to keep these surfaces as they are, and we are going to proceed to create the extrusion. So first, we will have to create the work plane for the extrusion, which is, as I mentioned before, at 250 from the XY plane. So we we'll have to create an offset plane from the x y plane, and the distance will be 250 millimeters. Then okay, next we will create the sketch, and we will be looking normal to the sketch plane, and we will create a cycle and then add a dimension. This value will be the B2 diameter. Then okay, next we will add the distance from this origin point to the center point, so the vertical distance should be 920 millimeters, and the horizontal distance from the center point to the origin should be 130 millimeters. Now you see that we do not need a huge portion of the surface, so we are going to trim them back later to keep only the portion which is useful for us. Okay, so we finish the sketch first, and for now we are going to create our extrusion using the sketch and using the XY plane to define the extent. So for the extent, we are going to switch this distance option to the 2 option, and we are going to select again the XY plane and okay. We will hide this plane first, not longer useful. And as you can see here, in order to properly trim the extrusion, we will need to first define a clean intersection between these two surfaces. And to do so, we are going to first trim both of them using the XY plane. And we'll use this trim surface tool. The cutting tool will be the XY plane. And for this first surface, we will remove this part like that. Then okay, we will invoke the trim surface tool again, and the cutting tool will be this XY plane again, and we remove this portion. We are going to add an additional plane to trim this somewhere like this in order to keep only what we need. So offset from plane option again, and we select the XZ plane, so the distance should be something like 800 millimeters, and we make sure that it is a minus in front, looking fine. Now we will invoke the trim surface tool again, we select the plane as the cutting tool, and remove this. Okay, one more time. So we trim using the plane and remove this. Then okay, now we will hide this, so we select the visibility, and now as you can see, there is a gap between these two surfaces, and in order to create a clean intersection, we will have to extend both of them and trim them back. So we will use the extend surface tool, select this edge first, and this distance 23 millimeters as the extent looks fine, so we'll just accept it. Then again, select this edge and okay. Now we will use the trim surface tool again. We select this as the cutting tool, and we will remove this portion. Then okay, trim surface again. We now use this as the cutting tool, and we should be removing this part, but as you can see, we cannot select it. I am not sure why this is happening, but the workaround I found was to use the extend surface to extend this side of this surface and this side also, so that it is larger than this one. Then okay, and now trim surface again, this as the cutting tool, and now we will see if we are able to remove this. Okay, and there we go. Wow, was difficult than anticipated, but there we go finally. And to finish, what we are going to do is to stitch this together so that it makes a single surface body. And for that purpose, we have this stitch surface tool, and we select this and that and click on apply, then done. And you can see here there is 5 surface body in our part, and this last body is the result of our last stitch surface operation. Now, to trim this extrusion to its final size, we are going to use the split tool, and we are going to make sure that we have this trim solid option, and we are going to select this body as the split tool. We have here the side that will be removed. It's not the correct one, so we will have to select this option for the opposite side and then OK. Now we will hide this stitch surface tool and take a close look on the result, and maybe we will hide all the surface body also, so these two visibility. And now we will hit this button to return to the assembly, and right away move to the 3D model tab and select the hole tool. As we did before, we are going to use this concentric option for the placement, and we select this plane, and the concentric reference will be this surface. We make sure that we have the tape hole option active, and we are going to change the thread type to the JB pipe threads. And for the size, we should select here 33.249, and that will give us a G1 GB pipe thread. The thread depth should be the 30 millimeters, so we will input here 30 millimeters. And for the termination, we will use again the two option, and we will select the XY plane from the origin folder, so like so, and then we will hit OK. And now, as you can see, the hole is created through these three components. And because we took the time beforehand to do the proper preparation, we did not have a warning or an error message, which is kind of nice, I must say. Okay, now we can collapse this and go back to the view rep node and activate the default view representation. And now you can see our assembly is complete. Wow, what a wonderful beast. My fellow card lovers, this is how to build the spiral casing in Autodesk Inventor using the skeleton modeling strategy. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and hopefully you learned something on the way. Stay tuned for more tutorials, and again, thanks for watching.